Good morning, Tehmina Khan is here in TK Maths S1. In today's video, I will explain to you a concept of trigonometry. And in this question, I will cover the concept of sine and cosine rule, angle of depression and elevation. This is a topic of the syllabus of O-level mathematics. And question I have picked up from CIE June 12, variant 22, question 9. And before I begin, you can see on the top my blog address, tkmaths1.blogspot.com, and my website address tkmaths.com. Do visit it, you will find it very useful. You will find all the videos I have made so far and solution of many challenging questions. So let's begin with the question. So this is the question given to you, and there are three parts of this question. So all the angles and values which are written here are explained in this paragraph also, in these lines. A, B, C, D are four points on the level ground, right? Calculate A, B. So let's look at this triangle. Will it help us to calculate the side A, B? So if you see here in this triangle, let me pick up a pen. So in this triangle, you don't know two sides. You know one side, which is 30, and you know two angles. So if you recall sine rule, the sine rule is applied when you know two angles and you know one side, right? So sine rule says ratio of side with the opposite angle. So if I write here sine rule, it will be sine 37. If you see here, 30 over sine 37 is equals to AB over sine 50, right? If you want to write sine 37 first, there is no problem. If you want to write it like this, sine 37 over 30 is equals to sine 58 upon AB. That is also fine, right? So you have to take the ratio of the side with the opposite angle. So there are three parts we know, one is unknown. So we can easily solve this equation. So cross multiply, it will be 30 times sine 58 divided by sine 37. And we will get the value of the length AB. And this will be in meters, because in the question it is given in meters. Next part of the question is saying find out or calculate AC. Then we will look at in this triangle. Right, this triangle. Now if you see, this triangle has at the moment only two sides. So we need to know one angle also. This is a straight line. It means the straight line is 180 degree. So from 180, if I minus 58, I will get this angle, yes? So this angle will be 122. Okay. Now if you remember, cosine rule says, if you know two sides and angle between them, then if you can recall, let me just write it here. For example, this is A, B, C, and this is 122, for example. Or let me write theta here, for example. So if I have to find this out, I can make it a subject. A square is equals to B square plus C square minus 2BC cos theta, right? So same formula we will apply here. AC is unknown side. So I will write AC square is equals to 30 square, this side, plus 64 square minus 2 times 30 times 64, as we have seen from the formula. And cos of 122, the angle which is between two known sides. And then simple use calculator to find out the value of AC. So it is 83.85 meter. Okay, now the last part of the question, rather second last, there is one more part, B. Calculate the area of triangle ADC. Now, this is not a right angle triangle, so we can't do half into base into height. So we know the area of triangle formula is half AB sine C. Now what is AB and sine C? If you draw any triangle and two sides which are known are AB, then the angle between them is C. So if this is the situation, then you can apply this formula for area of a triangle. So here I can, because I have found this in the previous part 122. So I can apply the formula. It will be half times 30 times 64. Into sine of 122, and then use calculator and find out area, and this is area, so it is a square meter, right? Now this part is little tricky, and you need to imagine a three-dimensional picture, because question is saying a vertical tower stand at A. So there is a tower. You can imagine like this is coming out. You know, I cannot draw here, but something is coming out towards you from point A, right? Imagine this is the ground, and from point A something is coming towards you, coming out from the board, from the paper. So that is the tower, height of the tower you have to calculate. Now let me try to explain this from here. For example, this is the top of the tower, which I said okay, if it is coming out towards you, then this is the top, right? And question is saying find the calculate the height of the tower, and it is written tower to the line BC is greatest. So angle of depression is greatest. What does it mean? First of all, to understand that depression angle of depression is when you look down from the top and the angle made between the horizontal line and the line which is joining from where you are watching and what you are watching. So this angle is called angle of depression. Now it is called greatest if it is perpendicular to the opposite side, right? So this tower which is coming out from here and this line is perpendicular. So I have tried to draw here. These are the two points on the surface, and this was the top of the tower which was emerging out from A. So question is saying this angle is 34, and we know that if this line is horizontal and this line is horizontal, then these angles are called alternate angles. So it means angle of depression will be equals to angle of elevation, because if you see something at the top from here, it will be same angle. Now in this diagram, at the moment I know only one angle, I don't know anything. So how will I calculate the top of the tower, height of the tower? So I need to see or find out some other dimensions of this triangle. So let's look at this side of the triangle. Okay, I know this is 58 and this is 30. And in this diagram, if I want to find out height of the tower, I need to know either TP or AP. So from this triangle, I can calculate AP very easily. Look at this diagram. Right? Right now, I have drawn this diagram as it is on the four-dimensional page paper. So now I will apply trigonometric ratio to find out AP, and that value of AP I will substitute here, right? So let's calculate the value of AP. I will use sine rule. So sine 58 is equals to AP over 30. So simple calculation, cross multiplication, and you've got the answer of AP. Now this value 25.4 you will write here. Okay, let's do it. So now 25.4 I'm writing here, and then I'm simply applying trigonometric ratio. So for this angle, this is opposite and this is adjacent, and I have to calculate this side. So I will write 1035 is equals to 80 upon 25.4. And simple calculation, you got the height of the tower. So in this question, you needed to understand that tower is coming out from the paper, or if you imagine it is on the ground, then it is going up from the ground. So this is what you need to visualize it, and then accordingly you have to divide this diagram into two parts to calculate it. If you have learned something from it and you liked it, please press like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. And the link of another video on trigonometry, which is related to bearing, is in the description box. So you can click on that link to learn about bearing and trigonometry, right? So thank you very much for watching this video. Do share it with your friends. Take care.